dairy farm in front of 12,000 people. Can you guys please make some noise and welcome him to this stage, y'all? Make some noise for Mark Marcel.
Shit, you already know. Yo, let me get a make money, money, make money, money, money.
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 Maybe the American government was onto something and they started putting up slogans with, "In God we trust" all over the currency. Because honestly, the way people worship money, you gotta imagine that they can find God in one of them dollar bills. Like it's just a new religion. Like the rich just keep getting richer with this type of greed that deceives that they were prepared to die and take all that shit with them. So I question if they ever read the Bible. Because I'm sure if God ever put up some cash, he wouldn't walk the paper with the faces of presidents. So I'm about to start printing up new money. But $1 bill to Bob Marley on the front for bluntness, man. And on the back, I have a photo of Fidel Castro waving a Cuban flag. And a close-up picture of him bending over his big Cuban ass. Just so I can see the expressions of the faces of the gluttons that roam around the White House administration, placing embargoes on countries because they can't get along with a few men. So I'm about to start putting up new money. But $5 bills more with the faces of miscellaneous third world children. Just when you go shopping on Rodeo Drive, I hope your conscience can just fuck with you the second you ask us to the cash register and you can see the people who you truly deprived. Because believe me, Fidel eats well. Him and Exxon got something in common. Their systems ain't going out of business. I mean, it's the only difference. At least he offered some type of relief during hurricane seasons while oil companies and sat back and got rich. So you tell me who's the communist. And me, I'm about to start printing up new money with $10 bills more with the faces of black men being hung from trees. Just so when brothers buy that dime bag of weed, they'll know what it really means to be hanging with your homies high on trees. And instead of having a pocket full of 20s, I just print up something new like $33 bills. just to print off the revelations that people live by with the faces of Bill Gates, Vanessa Del Rio, and Pablo Escobar, because this world seems like it could survive more for money, sex, and drugs. And just for Tim Hardaway's bitch ass, I'll start printing up $50 bills with the faces of hate crime victims, Matthew Shepard and Charles Howard. Just so homophobic people go broke, because they're ignorant and will get the hands of it by touching the money they can spend. Now start printing up $69 bills of all kind of photos of jails and sex toy items. Just for those in touch with their sexual preferences. And $99 bills. Just so people can stop trying to be perfect. Because life is all about growth and progress. And at least you have so much room to improve with 1% left. And my elusive $100 bill, I'll leave it plain without a marking on it. Just so families go ranch after the grocery stores and start filling the food out in their cabinets by duplicating the paper and making it whenever they wanted it. Now leave it bare. No face, no words, no number, just some cut out 2x6. Now leave it as is. Like you can take a crayon and start blending in whatever color you felt should be shaded in. Or maybe you just use a pen and write in whatever comment or slogan you felt you needed to get through the day. Now leave it blank, like it was as empty as nothing. And it's pure, it's faith. Because if you trust in God, you would know money ain't worth shit anyway. Maybe there's something I'm missing. My homeboy is saying no real player. Because if I was, I'd gather up one of these boys that call themselves my fans and have them financing my tours and trips. He says if I was a real pimp like him, I'd have them taking me out on dinners and vacations. Maybe she'll even tap into her savings. He said, I should be waiting for her to pull out her credit card. I should be driving her car. He said, man, if they ain't telling you how long for them to throw you some yards, your pimp game must be second string. So I said to him two things here. One, I don't fuck for my rent. My homeboys know, when you need someone to take one for the team, they ain't calling me. I'm as shallow as it gets when it comes to where I'm gonna place my dick. And I said to him two, damn, dude, your exes must hate you. They probably talk about like a disease they once had, like they probably even regret fucking you. Probably tell the girlfriends all kind of bad things about you, say all kind of dirt about you. Nah, better yet, they probably don't even talk about you. Like, they just want to forget about you. I mean, if you can live with knowing the people who you share memories with want nothing more than forget you even exist, then play, what the fuck are you even here for? And I can assure you, most of the women I spent time with looks back on those moments like, damn, that was the shit. But you, they probably like, damn, he ain't shit. And I know there's a few aspiring pimps in here thinking, yeah, man, whatever, homie, I got my shorty on a leash. But yeah, man, whatever, homie, that's only because she's weak. And it's only a matter of time before she realizes she's not a lesbian and go find herself a real dick. Sure, yes, I am single. But on the real, you shouldn't have to accompany yourself with these type of men. Men shouldn't bitch up in the middle of the night, call you, ask you if they have $1,100 for the rent. Just to turn around and post a picture of him flashing $1,100 bills on his Twitter account. You should have turned around and posted a picture of you taking $1,100 bills and slapping a manhood back in his grill. Because sister, I keep on hearing you want a real man, but you just keep fucking with babies. Maybe you should cancel your dinner reservations and take this dude to Chuck E. Cheese. Don't worry about dressing him in the latest fashion. His ass should be happy with Baby Gap. Oh, they're so cute. The way that women dress them, feed them, change them, bathe them. It's like they have a mother all over again. So maybe it's the women who are to blame. Because maybe someone should arrest you for having sex with children. Maybe this is something I'm not getting. I tend to get annoyed when boys start repeating themselves. No, I don't need my pillow fluff. No, I don't feel like talking about my poems. No, the temperature's fine. If I were cold, I'd tell you so. No, I don't need you to get up and hand me the remote. If I were, goddamn, this is gonna start looking like I ain't got no hands. I'd rather you take a note from Henry Rollins and tell me 10 things I didn't know. I need a woman to make me be like, damn, she's a shit. Not a woman to make me be like, damn, she's annoying as shit. And my homeboys say there's something I'm not getting it. They say I'm not no real pimp, no real player. I ain't got no real broads that'll wash my drawers and treat me like I'm a king Pied Piper. So I guess the only thing I want to ask them is now, when y'all spending quality time together, and after she cooks you dinner and puts your ass to bed, how often does she have to change your diapers? Shit is beautiful, man. I don't mean y'all being here. Y'all being here is awesome, but life. To be able to touch this, to be able to speak, to be able to share. We take it for granted. We take it for granted. You have to understand, first of all, I'm not really Mark. I know you guys are about to say Jesus or something. No. I'm an energy occupying the body that people know as Mark. And that's what everybody here is energy. You are all enlightened beings. You're not human. Human beings, what's fun for human beings is video games, jewelry, clothes. Ooh, you see that new fresh pair of shoes? That's fun for human beings. What's fun for enlightened beings? To give yourself these problems that we can work through. You are not checker players. You are chess players. Your problems, first of all, are bullshit. It's the energy you give it. Look at it this way. Would you rather have problems or not be here? It's simple, ain't it? And when you think about it like that, you're like, whoa, I'm fucking glad I'm here. Give me these problems. I'll take these motherfuckers. We take that shit for granted. It's This shit is the most beautiful experience we've ever given ourselves. What we all are, we are all connected, we are all a piece, and we all are God that has forgotten on purpose to live this, because knowing everything is boring. What do you do? I'm gonna break myself down and forget. Souls, I'm gonna come out here and forget I know everything and play and learn and question and experience, because it's fun. This shit is fun. I can feel the weight on my back every time I sit secluded at my desk, trying to find the words that I need to flow right out of my pen. I can feel the burden I'm carrying every time I read my verse and start spending the next few hours editing. I can feel the boulders on my shoulders every time I walk up into the venue, and every time the host calls my name, and every time I adjust the mic stand to fit my 6'3" body frame. I can feel the shit everywhere I go. I can feel the masses of people's souls have been added to my heart, much like extra cargo. Much like every time they drop a rhyme, I'm confined to their cries, because I stopped doing this shit for me a long time ago. Because see, if that was the case, I would have just stayed my ass home and get to Hawaii is a long 11-hour motherfucking plane ride. I'd have just kept my shit in journals, wouldn't have thought of labeling the poem. Now, I'm the last person I know to call myself a poet, but that's because when I was writing verses, I just didn't want to bring any disrespect to the meaning of the word. And while I've heard some poets get on this mic and say they do this shit for themselves first, while I heard some cats say they do this shit for the accolades or just to get paid or just because it gives them kicks when they spit and hit the crowd going crazy, I do this shit for cats that don't even write poetry. I do this shit for cats that don't even like poetry. I do this shit for the little boy down the street where his father told him he grew up to amount to shit, and that's what he grew up to believe. I get on this mic for mothers who fall work and two or more hour jobs. I spit my lyrics for the little sister thinking about a man I knew, but hoping I might hit her with something that just might change her mind. There's another power you can do when someone feels like they can just reach out and touch your rhyme. I know the feeling you get from being lifted up for one single line. I do this shit for all the people politicians make promises with just to get elected only to leave them deprived. I do this shit for all the little white lies. I do this shit for all the sisters they raped and all the brothers they whipped and lynched and all the families they packed on slaves into transport. I do this shit for airmen trying to get through airports or driving cabs in New York. I do this shit for black men in court. I do this shit for little white boys being molested but they're too scared to tell their parents what the preachers told them about the sins of God's creations. I don't do this shit for stardom or to win slams. I do this shit just so the president knows who the fuck I am. I do this shit for all the rappers who can't rap and all the MCs that never got a chance and all the men that never got the chance to lock down a pen and all the men that institutions got locked down in the pen. I do this shit for all the kids teachers say something's just missing and for all the juvenile delinquents principals just refuse to take the time to understand. I do this shit for all the cats that say they want to get on the mic but it just brings them fright to know they can be exposed and naked to people when they're up there spitting their lyrics. And I can feel the weight of the world every time I spit a verse and every time I rehearse in the mirror. I can hear them echo the words in my head trying to form poems of broken sentences, and I've never had the pressures being lifted off me when I pick up my pen. So I guess I have no choice. Because even though they can't form the poetry, they still need a voice. Thank y'all.